I'm Catherine Roseland here with Board Game Geek TV at Spiel 2014. I'm sitting here with David Duperat from
Nice
Geek Editions.
Meet you.
And he's here to talk about their new game, Gaia.
Yeah. So Gaia is a new game from a new Canadian company, publishing company, which name is Tiki. So Gaia is, if we want to summarize that, you create a world, you build city on this world, and you try to win by putting your five meeples on the world. In fact, there are no victory points in this game.
Oh, interesting.
During the game, you will build something with tiles. For that, you will play cards that give you the opportunity to complete and expand the world. And during that, you will try to put cities on tiles. That's why these cards have this strange format, because they must fit on the cards. So before entering the details, just to have a quick overview of the rules. The rules is pretty simple. You have to know that it's a family game. We try to cut the rules in two parts: family rules, advanced rules,
okay,
more for
nice.
Gamers. In the family rules, the principle is pretty simple. When it's your turn, you have two actions. The actions are draw cards or play cards. So you can draw, play, etc.
And you choose one thing to do each turn.
Exactly.
Yeah. Great.
There are three types of cards. The first type of cards are creation cards. These are the cards
that let you play
yes.
pieces on the board.
Simple as that. Okay, you play this one, you keep that. You have to know that during the creation of the world, you keep all the proof that you create the world in front of you. Because if you're the first to success an objective, there are always some objective near the game. You can take the objective, like the objective, and you put a meeple on it. So the first way to get rid of our meeple or people is to succeed, to be the first to do objective cards.
Okay. Okay, and how many objectives will there be in each game you play?
Every time, two more than the number of players.
Okay, so if we're a two-player game, then there'll be four objectives. Okay.
That's it. If we are four, there will be six.
Great.
Okay? So first way to get rid of our little meeples are the objective cards. The other way, during the play, we create the world, and we will try the other way to put your meeple on Gaia is to use the city cards. I don't know if you can see these cities how they are. To put a city card, you have to respect what the city needs.
Okay, so this one needs
to... This one needs to be put on a desert. And then you have to respect at least two needs. So for example, this card, I can't put it here because it's on a desert and I have two C. So it's okay. As I do that, I put a meeple on it.
Fantastic.
So. But if you expand, if you improve the satisfaction of the city, you can, for example, play a forest mm-hmm. with that. You put a forest. The city didn't have the forest. So you improve the city.
So I get to put a meeple on as well.
Yes.
Fantastic.
That's the way it works.
And it's the first person to get rid of all your meeples.
Lucky.
Great.
So that is a family game.
How long will a family game usually take?
Family or advanced game, it's half an hour. With a heavy gamer and a lot of thinking, we can go to 40 minutes. But it's really...
It's a quick game.
Yes. And a thing very interesting is it was a must-have for me. It can be played with two players. Because
That's
I play
important.
A lot with my girlfriend, and we need a game that can be played quickly with two players, and it's not less agreeable with two. Okay?
Great.
And let's talk about now the advanced rules,
mm-hmm.
because we have
some
more
time.
As I said, to put the rule stays the same. For example, for this one, I can put my meeple on it. But if you improve a city, you remove my nipple and you put yours.
Instead. So that makes it so that you are careful about building a city somewhere
it's a more aggressive game. And a third deck of cards appears. In the first deck of cards, as we saw, we can draw a card that allows you to put tiles on the world. These ones, exactly. The second deck put things on the...
Yeah, so these are cities and buildings of some kind.
Exactly. For example, you have cities or animals.
When
you put animals, you put four tokens on a tile, like it is shown on this. And it's another way to improve a city. For example, this one needs to see one forest and to be complete also animals. So if I put animals here, I improve the city. And it's not only improving, I do a complete city. Everything is done. So
you get to put two
meeples. So it's the fast track to win a game.
Great.
And last of all, for fun, because it's also a very fun part, when you place the advanced rule, you use
disaster
cards.
Like.
Exactly. In fact, this game brings some havoc in the game, but these cards are pretty cool. For example, if you use the earthquake, you can take two tiles, swap them, and after you look what happens. If you take, for example, the sun gives you the opportunity to take one plane and transform it
into
a desert. That's it. So there are seven power cards, we will say, because they are not always disasters. Because
they did change things.
Yes, they change things. In fact, the first deck of cards, you put tiles. The second deck of cards, you put things on the tiles. And when you're in the advanced rule, with the third deck of cards, you move everything.
Yeah.
It's a very good way to improve, decrease the city needs, mm-hmm. and try to prevent your opponent from winning. It's more
chaos.
A tactic than a strategy. You have to think to the what is the best game each turn.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, when you draw cards, you have the choice between drawing one of the face-up cards or one of the top of the deck. I think I've explained almost all the game.
Fantastic.
So it's simple as that. We had a lot of fun with that. Just for you to know, it already won a prize in Quebec.
Fantastic. That's
it. I hope you will enjoy it.
Great. And so about a half an hour, 40 minutes.
Yes. For those who say, oh yes, but there are no icons on the power cards. No, we choose not to put icons because we really like the illustration of the cards.
Yeah, I noticed the art is really, really nice, and all the different tiles have different art on them.
Everything is different.
And,
it's very appealing. So you have to know that the last page of the rule is all the explanation of the seven power cards. You can do that. That's it.
That's great. Great. That was Gaia.
That was
from
Gaia.
Tiki Edition.
Tiki Edition.
Fantastic. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you so much.